Good evening, children. Welcome to AIIMS India online classes. Today we are going to discuss about the cell structure and function. In this we already started. We completed about the cell membrane and the structure of a typical cell. Let us proceed. Cell wall. In a plant cell, there is an extra layer mainly of cellulose outside the cell membrane, which is known as the cell wall. The cell wall is a tough, rigid but flexible porous layer that lends a definite shape to the cell, and it also provides protection. It is present only in the plant cell. It contains three layers in many plants. The three layers are middle lamella, primary cell wall, the secondary cell wall, like this. Primary cell wall, secondary cell wall, and middle lamella. So these are the plasma desmata are also the part of this cell wall only, which helps in connecting with the adjacent cells. These are the plasma desmata. This helps in connecting. This is one cell, and this is another cell. The two cells here also, see, this is plasma desmata, which helps in connecting with the adjacent cells. Okay, so these plasma desmata. So this is the cell wall. Cell wall gives complete protection. And further, next slide we can see the functions. So primarily, the structure of cell wall, it is consisting of three layers. The cell wall is present above the plasma membrane or cell membrane. The three layers are primary cell wall, middle lamella, and secondary cell wall. Let us proceed. The main function of cell wall, if you take it is the main layer which gives the definite shape and protection to the plant cells, and also it exerts it protects the plant cell from different pressures, and it is the unique difference. Cell wall is the unique difference between the plant cell and animal cell. So let us proceed to the next cell organelle, nucleus. Nucleus is the dense and spherical organelle. Nucleus is bounded by two membranes, both forming a nuclear envelope. A nuclear envelope is nothing but a double membrane layer surrounding the nucleus, particularly in eukaryotic cells. Nuclear envelope contains many pores. These pores are known as nuclear pores. See here. The nuclear envelope, this is the double membrane nuclear envelope. It is possessing some pores, means gaps. These gaps are called as nuclear pores. This is the nucleus. Nuclear envelope, the outer double layered membrane surrounding the nucleus. And in order to study this nucleus, some activities are given. It is very easy to conduct those activities. To observe the nucleus in cheek cells, you need a toothpick or an ice cream spoon or a spatula, a glass slide over cover slip, watch glass, needle, and a blotting paper. So procedure is very simple. Wash your mouth and scrape a little of internal lining of your mouth. Then place that scraping in a watch glass containing a very small quantity of saline liquid. Then after that, transfer that material into a glass slide and add some coloring agent, methylene blue. So this methylene blue, and wait for 2 minutes. Then later, wipe off the extra stain with a fine cloth or blotting paper. Then put the drop of glycerin over it and place a cover slip. Then a slide is formed. You need to take some precautions. Then observe that temporary mount under the low and high power of microscope, and you will find the cytoplasm, cell membrane and nucleus, and you can draw the picture while observing. Okay, so nucleus is the most prominent cell organelle, means which is easily visible with the help of a microscope. You can easily judge or observe the nucleus. So next, the fluid which is present inside the nucleus is called as nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm. Next, the nucleus contains chromosomes, and the chromosomes contain genes. Very important, chromosomes and genes. So this is the chromatin material. These thread-like structures which are present inside the nucleus, it is called chromatin material. This chromatin material contains chromosomes. On the chromosomes, genes are located. So these genes are called as the centers of genetic information. Okay, children, nucleus, it is a spherical organelle, and it is present in the center of the cell. It is visible with an ordinary microscope also. And but in order to study the total components of nucleus, you need to utilize electron microscope. Electron microscopes are not available in the laboratories. So with the help of already mounted slides, already prepared slides also, you can observe under microscope. You can see this structure, nucleus. Let us discuss more about nucleus. Nucleus functions, if you take, nucleus controls all the metabolic activities of the cell. Metabolic activities means remaining all, cell is called the structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So at the cellular level only, there are different metabolic activities takes place, like cellular digestion, cellular respiration, okay, cellular transport. So these are all the activities which help the cell to be alive. They are called metabolic activities, or simply life processes or life activities. Okay, so just like our brain controls all the functions of the body, nucleus controls all metabolic activities of the cell. Like it regulates the cell cycle. Cell cycle is nothing but reproduction, cell division or cell reproduction. Nucleus is the storehouse of genes, means whatever the chromosomes, they are present in the nucleus, so it is called as a storehouse of genes. Next, it is concerned with the transmission of hereditary traits, means hereditary characters, from parent to offspring. So if you see this nucleus, the nuclear envelope particularly, it is present in the eukaryotic cell. This is the eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell consisting of nuclear envelope. Nuclear envelope is present only in the eukaryotic cell. It is absent in the prokaryotic cell. In the prokaryotic cell, there is no separate nucleoplasm, nucleolus, like the different structures are not there. Only nucleoid. This nucleoid is nothing but the genetic material in a circular genetic material is present, DNA or RNA, so it is called a nucleoid. Okay, it is simple. But whereas in the eukaryotic cell, separate everything is well developed nucleus is present with double layered nuclear envelope. Okay, children. And more about the functions, if you see this nucleus, it regulates and controls all the functions of the cell and determines the characteristics of organisms, because it contains all the genetic information. The nucleus closely involved in the process of cell division. What is that membrane covering the nucleus? Nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane. It is very similar to cell membrane. Almost the entire genetic material of the cell is found in the nucleus only. Okay, in the form of chromatin material. On the basis of absence or presence of the organized nucleus in the cells are of two types. What are they? What are they, children? Eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. So let us study more about this eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell. What is a prokaryotic cell? Pro means primitive. Karyon means nucleus. A cell with primitive nucleus is called prokaryotic cell. The size of this prokaryotic cell is generally between 1 to 10 millimeter. Very small. The nucleus is actually absent in prokaryotic cell. It contains single chromosome. Prokaryotic cell contains a single chromosome. Nucleolus is absent. The colorful structure which is present in the nucleus. So that is as the nuclear membrane is also absent, nucleolus is also absent. The membrane bound cell organelles are absent. So in the typical cell, in the last class, we studied that there are several membrane bounded organelles like mitochondria, Golgi complex, okay, ribosomes, lysosomes, chloroplasts, like the different membrane bounded organelles are absent in the prokaryotic cell. It is also one of the major difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Cell division takes place by simple binary fission or budding. Cell division is taking place by simple binary fission or by budding. So let us see examples. There are several examples are there for these prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells example, bacterium, cyanobacteria, blue-green algae. Okay, these are primitive organisms come under prokaryotic cells category. So here the structure of bacteria, if you see, cell membrane is present, cell wall is present, and there is no nucleus, only chromosome or nucleoid is present. Okay, so this simple structure, there is no nuclear envelope. So here the size is also very small, 1 to 10 millimeter. Microscopic size, we can't see the bacteria, and the nucleus is absent, contains single chromosome, so only one chromosome is present, nucleolus is absent, and the membrane bound cell organelles except ribosomes, remaining all cell organelles are absent, and the cell division takes place by binary fission, simply the nuclear material and cytoplasm equally divided into two parts, and the one bacteria divides into two, that is called binary fission. Next, eukaryotic cell. Eu means true, karyon means nucleus. The cell with a true nucleus is called a eukaryotic cell. Okay, children, the size of the cell is generally large. there only 1 to 10 millimeters, here 5 to 100 millimeters size. Nucleus is present. It contains more than one chromosome. Chromosomes are more in number. Nucleolus is present. Membrane bound cell organelles such as mitochondria, plastids, and many more are present. Cell division takes place by mitotic or meiotic cell division. They are advanced cell divisions present in eukaryotic cell. Here one plant cell is taken. Here it is an eukaryotic cell because it possesses a well-developed nucleus, and it also possesses membrane-bounded cell organelles, vacuole, chloroplast, mitochondria. Nucleus is also membrane-bound organelle. Ribosomes, very small organelles, and cell wall, cell membrane. So the cell membrane, ribosomes, cytoplasm. These are the common structures present in both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. The main difference is nucleus is not surrounded by nuclear envelope, and membrane bound organelles are absent in the prokaryotic cell. They are present in the eukaryotic cell. This is the difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Let us proceed further. Important structure, cytoplasm. What is cytoplasm? The fluid or the matrix present inside the cell, bounded by cellular membrane, cell membrane. It is called as a cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is also called as the matrix of the cell. The cytoplasm or the fluid present inside the nucleus is called nucleoplasm. But here, cytoplasm. It is a jelly-like, viscous, colorless, semi-fluid substance. It is jelly-like, viscous, colorless, semi-fluid substance. It occurs between the plasma membrane or cell membrane and nuclear membrane. So this is nuclear membrane. The gap between the nuclear membrane and cell membrane is filled with a cytoplasm. You can define the fluid present in the cell between nuclear membrane and cell membrane is called cytoplasm. Okay. The aqueous ground substance of cytoplasm is called cytosol. This is called cytosol. Cytosol means the fluid part. Okay. Aqueous means which contain more water. It contains a variety of cell organelles and other insoluble waste products and storage products like starch, glycogen, lipids, okay. Different chemical substances or macromolecules are present in the cytoplasm. Even hormones, they are also present dissolved in the cytoplasm. Actually, the cytoplasm is divided into protoplasm and cytoplasm. There is some difference between a protoplasm and a cytoplasm. Actually, the living portion or the fluid which is present inside the cell, it is called as a protoplasm, which means life fluid. The cytoplasm contains the living part. It is called as a protoplasm. The meaning is life fluid. It when it became clear that the fluid is basically a medium in which various particles and membranes float around, and the functions of the cell activity takes place in the cytoplasm only. Several metabolic activities takes place in this cytoplasm of the cell. And the protoplasm was renamed. First, actually, it was called the protoplasm. Later, it was named as a cytoplasm. that is nothing but a cell fluid. Protoplasm means life fluid, cytoplasm means cell fluid. So this cytoplasm consisting of the nucleus and other cell organelles, all are embedded in this cytoplasm. Okay, and the fluid part which is present inside the nucleus, it is called as nucleoplasm. So how this nucleus controls all the activities of the cell means, because of these nuclear pores, the cytoplasm enters into the nucleus, so that the nucleus makes its contact with all the organelles present inside the cell, so that as the genetic material is present inside the nucleus, it can send the commands to different cell organelles to perform the specific activities. Okay children, let us see the functions of this cytoplasm. The protoplasm acts as a store of vital chemicals like amino acids, proteins, sugars, vitamins, hormones, etc. Proteins means nothing but the hormones are also contain proteins only. This cytoplasm is the site of certain metabolic reactions like glycolysis, means it is a part of respiration, glycolysis, synthesis of fatty acids, nucleotides, etc. These are all the activities, metabolic activities takes place inside the cytoplasm. The maximum portion of the cytoplasm contains water. 80 to 90% of this cytoplasm contains water. So in the beginning it was called protoplasm, which means life fluid. Later it was named as cytoplasm, nothing but cell fluid. Let us proceed to next part of the lesson, cell organelles. What are cell organelles? The cell organelles are nothing but the minute structures which are embedded in the cytoplasm of the cell, called as cell organelles, which include mitochondria, plastids, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosomes, vacuoles, etc. They are very important because they carry out very crucial functions. Let us study first cell organelle Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus. So this is the Golgi apparatus. This Golgi apparatus, it was discovered or observed by Camillo Golgi. The name itself, Camillo Golgi, had observed this organelle in the year 1898 using a optical microscope. Its final structure, when it observed under the electron microscope, this is the structure. It consists of a set of membranes, set of membrane bound fluid filled vesicles called vacuoles. Okay, it contains set of, these are the vacuoles actually, secretory vesicles or vacuoles, and flattened cisternae, and flattened cisternae. These are the two important structures, vesicles and cisternae. The cisternae are usually arranged parallel to each other. These cisternae are arranged to parallel to each other, one over the other. So these are cisternae. Okay, one like this. They are arranged parallel to each other. Okay, next there is a gap present between this cisternae. It is called as a lumen, the space. More about this Golgi complex. Golgi apparatus functions, if you take The Golgi apparatus are sac-like structures. The main function of this Golgi apparatus is to store, modify, package and dispatch the substances like proteins. Okay, its main function is storage, modify, package and dispatch the substances. Next, it also involved in the synthesis of cell wall in plant cells, synthesis of plasma membrane in animal cells, and also lysosomes. Also lysosomes are also present in the animal cells. So incoming transport vesicles, so it newly forms the vesicles always. So front portion, cis phase and trans phase, two phases are there. The secretory vesicles, they secrete proteins, or we can say the Golgi apparatus is secretory in function. The number of Golgi bodies or Golgi apparatus varies from cell to cell. Their number are particularly large in those cells that secrete hormones and enzymes. Okay, it secretes proteins. So hormones and enzymes contain proteins. So in the secretory organelles or secretory organs like digestive glands are there. So this Golgi apparatus number will be more in particular organs where secretion is needed. In those organs, in those cells of those organs contain more number of Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex. So due to its complex structure, it is called as a Golgi complex also. Let us proceed. Endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is another very important structure. It is also observed when you observe under electron microscope only. It is an electron microscopic structure, membrane bounded organelle. It is a membranous network of tube-like structures extending from nuclear membrane. This is the nucleus, the nuclear membrane, this blue color one. From this nuclear membrane, this Golgi, this endoplasmic reticulum extends. It extends from nuclear membrane. It is absent in prokaryotic cells. So membrane bounded organelles are absent in the prokaryotic cell. It is present in the eukaryotic cells only, but mature RBC or red blood cell of mammals also prokaryotic cell only. It also lacks endoplasmic reticulum. Next, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. Our endoplasmic reticulum exists in two forms, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum exists in two forms, children, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, in short form RERSER. So what is the difference between these two? Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is so called because the surface is smooth, whereas the rough endoplasmic reticulum, the surface is covered by some granules called ribosomes. So this is the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which possess ribosomes. Rough endoplasmic reticulum possess ribosomes on its surface, that's why it appears to be rough. Let us see the functions. The endoplasmic reticulum is a large network of membranes. It is a largest organelle, it is one of the, so it is large network of membrane bound tubes and sheets. It is similar to the structure of plasma membrane only, and it functions, if you take There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, as we know that. Let us once again see the differences. Rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum consists of ribosomes. They are present on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum and helps in the synthesis of proteins. It is the function of rough endoplasmic reticulum. Whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are absent and its function is synthesis of lipids. Okay, the main function of this endoplasmic reticulum, once again, the endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum possessing some granules. It gives internal support to the cell. Okay, it is a large tubular structure attached to the nucleus. This is the nuclear envelope. From the nuclear envelope, this endoplasmic reticulum arises. So, it gives internal support to the cell because it is made up of some different tube-like structures. It helps in the transport of various substances like proteins and lipids. Transport is another very important function of transport of materials, especially proteins and lipids. The transport takes place between the cytoplasm and nucleus. It also forms, it also functions as a cytoplasmic framework, providing a surface for some of the biochemical activities of the cell. So, rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes the proteins and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes the lipids. So, one of the interesting character in vertebrate liver cells, in vertebrate, higher vertebrates which possess backbone. So, in those animals, the liver cells, smooth endoplasmic reticulum plays a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs. So, liver is called as a detoxifying organ. So, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum of vertebrates, liver, helps in the detoxification. What is the meaning of detoxification? Detoxification means converting the high toxic material, poisonous material, into low toxic material. So, it is a biochemical process. So, smooth endoplasmic reticulum of the liver helps in this process. So, whatever the medicine you take, so first it goes to the liver, and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum present in the liver will detoxify that without changing its chemical composition. And then only that drug mixes with the blood and goes to the target organ. So, liver is the factory of the body, largest organ of the body, internal. So, it is one of the important function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So, once again, rough endoplasmic reticulum main function is protein synthesis. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum main function is lipid synthesis. Along with that, very important function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, what is that? Detoxification of poisons and drugs only in higher vertebrates. Let us proceed. So, this is the lesson today, and let us test ourselves how far we have understood. The quiz number 2. First question, Dash directs all cell activities through the DNA located there. which directs all the cell activities? Children, respond. Yes, nucleus. Nucleus is the cell organelle which directs, because it contains the DNA, so it directs all cell activities. That's why nucleus is also called cell brain. Next question, what is the name of the genetic material that is inside the nucleus? RER, SMR, ribosomes, DNA. What do you call the genetic material, children? Yes, DNA. This is the DNA. D is the correct answer. What is the full form of DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Deoxyribonucleic acid is the genetic material present in the nucleus. Where this DNA is present? Actually, in the genes. Okay? Chromosomes. Chromosomes containing genes. Genes containing genetic material called DNA. Next, what is the gel-like substance inside the cells called? Stroma, grana, water, cytoplasm. What is that gel-like substance? Yes, cytoplasm, cell fluid. Next, what organelle surrounds and supports plant cells? Cell membrane, cell wall, nucleus, Golgi complex. Guess, children? Cell wall. Cell wall gives support and shape and also protects the plant cell. The cell wall is made up of primary wall, secondary wall, middle lamellum. So it is mainly made up of which material? Cellulose. The chemical composition of cell wall is made up of cellulose. Next question. It gives the cells a rigid box-like shape outside of the cell membrane in plant cells. What is that? Cell membrane, cell wall, nucleus, chromatin. Obviously, cell wall. Cell wall is the structure which gives the shape to the plant cell. Next question. Which part of plant cell or which part of the cell is often called cell brain, the brain of the cell? Nuclear membrane, endoplasmic membrane, nucleus, Golgi complex. What is that which is called the brain of the cell? Yes, nucleus. Nucleus is the brain of the cell. Next, iron protein packing and shipping machine, which is that organelle? Who am I? Nuclear membrane, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, and Golgi complex. Which is called a protein packing organelle or shipping machine inside the cell? Yes, children, here see the clue, the diagram. What is this organelle? Easily you can guess. Yes, D, Golgi complex. D is the right option. Next, what is this? Here, see the diagram. What is this? I am giving clue. It is arrived or arises from nuclear membrane. It exists in two forms. On this structure, rough granules are present. What is this structure? Endoplasmic reticulum. Yes, endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, children, we studied about today about the important structure, cell wall, nucleus, cytoplasm, and endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex. Okay, briefly once recall, what is the function of cell wall? It provides shape, structure, and protection. And it gives rigidity and flexibility to the plant cell. And the nucleus is called as the cell brain. It contains all the genetic information, and based on that nuclear membrane, how many types of cells are there? Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells, examples, children: cyanobacteria, blue green algae, and bacteria. Eukaryotic cells, example: plant cells, animal cells. Next, what is cytoplasm? The cytoplasm is the fluid content present between the plasma membrane and nuclear membrane. And it contains cell organelles performing different functions. What are cell organelles? Cell organelles are enclosed by membrane. In prokaryotic cell, they are absent, but the membrane bounded cell organelles are present in the eukaryotic cells. And we also studied about the endoplasmic reticulum. It is it exists in two forms: rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum contains the ribosomes. The function is protein synthesis. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum function is synthesis of lipids. And Golgi complex main function is the packing and the transport of proteins and lipids, or secretion is the main function of Golgi complex. Next question. This can be found in the nucleus and or tiny strands that contain the instructions for directing the cell's function. DNA or chromatin, chloroplast, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex. What is it? DNA or chromatin. So it is found in the nucleus and or it contains tiny strands. Tiny strands are called as chromatin, that contain the instructions called genes. Okay, genes are made up of DNA. What is the full form? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, children, I hope you understood the today's topic. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving the latest updates. Thank you.